Friends, welcome to my channel. I decided to make this video because many people asked me that how to get Canada PR from India. So I'm going to discuss about multiple programs to obtain Canada permanent residence from India. I will also share the official website link for each program so you can explore in detail. These links are available in the video description box. By the end of this video, you will be able to learn about following things. The number one is how to get the Canada PR, how to find the best immigration programs for Canada PR, which are the top 5 categories of Canadian permanent residency, and 5 best provincial nominee programs for Indians to immigrant Canada. So guys, before I start, please do subscribe my channel for the latest updates and videos about Canada immigration. Okay, so if you are looking to apply for Canada permanent residence, the first step is to assess which program give you the best chance of success. It means that you need to find out which program matches with your profile, and that will help you to get Canada PR in fastest, easiest and cheapest way. So now let's see the 5 main categories of Canadian permanent residence. The first category is Express Entry Program. This is one of the most popular ways to migrate to Canada. And this program assesses the eligibility of candidate based on their skills and points. It means that you will be given certain points based on your skills, and your profile will be created. Now let's see, open the official link of Express Entry Program. So you can see this is an official website of Government of Canada, which can give you this information about the Express Entry Program. So let's open the link. So this is the official link of Express Entry System, and it tells us about the application process for skilled immigrants who want to settle in Canada permanently. Skilled immigrant means is a worker who have the special skill and training, and these skills may have been obtained from college, university or a technical school. Such examples of skilled immigrants like engineers, scientists, software developers, police officers, soldiers, physicians, plumber, cook, electrician and many more. Now let's see, these are the various steps that you have to follow if you want to apply for the Express Entry. The first link is how the Express Entry works. It gives you the idea about the application process and its eligibility. Eligibility which includes work experience, education and the language skills. Then you need to collect the various documents. You need to collect the documents like language test results such as IELTS, your education assessment, let's say for example through WAS, if you have a job offer, then you can attach that, police clearance certificate, medical exams and proof of funds. Then you have to create the profile and wait for the invitations to apply. Once you get the invitations, then you can apply for permanent residence. You can fill the forms, upload the documents, pay the fees and submit your applications. And if your application is approved, then you will become a Canada PR from the India. Now let's see how this express entry works. Let's click on this link. So you will see this page and you will see that these are the various steps that you have to follow. Just click on the details requirement for each program. Now let's see that express entry program is divided into the three different economic programs. These three programs are Federal Skill Worker Program, commonly known as FSWP, and another one is Federal Skilled Trade Program, FSTP, and the third one is Canadian Experience Class. So if you are a skilled worker, then these two programs are best suitable for you. And if I will talk about this program in the last section of the video. So now if you want to explore some more details about FSWP and FSTP, you can use this official link to obtain the more information. So I hope these things will be clear. Now let's move to the another category. The next category is the PNP, which is also very much important to obtain Canada PR. If you opt for provincial nominee program to apply your PR visa, then these are the steps that you should follow. The first thing is you have to apply to the province or the regions where you desire to settle. It means that instead of applying directly to express entry system, you have to apply to the province. In Canada, there are many provinces such as Ontario, British Columbia, Manitoba, Saskatchewan, Prince Edward Island. So for each province, they have their specific PNP programs. And you have to get the nomination from the province if your profile meets the eligibility criteria. So once you get the nomination, then you can apply for the PR through the express entry program or through the paper-based application. Now the question is, in which program I have to apply, or which program that I have to choose, whether I have to go for the express entry program or I have to go for the provincial nominee program. So the answer is, if your points is not high enough, it means that if your CRS point is not high enough to get invitations to apply for Canada PR from the express entry system, then you should choose this option. And believe me friends, this is the one of the best option to immigrant in Canada. You can choose your province where your profile will be matched easily. And what are the advantages of this PNP program is that you will get 600 CRS point. You will get 600 CRS point in your express entry application. In your express entry application, and makes you eligible to apply for your PR visa. So I hope the things are clear to you. If you are eligible to apply in the express entry program directly, then you can opt the first program. If you do not have the sufficient score, then you can go for the provincial nominee program. Now the another question would come in our mind is that, which are the best PNP programs for Indians to immigrate to Canada? So let's talk about five best PNP programs for the immigration to Canada. The first program, and which is most popular, we call it as SINP, Saskatchewan Immigrant Nominee Program. Other program is Alberta Immigrant Nominee Program, Ontario Immigrant Nominee Program, British Columbia Provincial Nominee Program, and Manitoba Provincial Nominee Program. So if you have any friends who is currently in the Manitoba, then this program is best suitable for you, MPNP. In Saskatchewan Immigrant Nominee Program, you do not require any job offer. Directly you can apply for the nomination. So now let's open the official link for the Provincial Nominee Program. And this is the official page of Provincial Nominee Programs. So you will get the information about how to apply in the Provincial Nominee Program as well as through the Express Entry. So now let's click on the Provincial Nominee Program. And let's say we have this link. So you will get all the information how to apply. Either you want to apply through the paper-based application or you want to apply through the Express Entry Program. And you will see the list of province. So you can see these are the list of province where for each province they run the specific programs, and you will get the more information about it by just clicking the link. Let's say I click on the Saskatchewan, and let's see, this link will be open about SINP program. So you can read the information if you are interested. So now let's come back to our main part. So this is the another main category of Canada PR. Now the third most important category, that is family class immigration. So here, if you have any relative in Canada and if he or she is 18 years old and Canadian citizen or permanent resident, then he or she can sponsor you. So if you have any relative in Canada, then this program is best suitable to you. Let's open the official link for this program if you want to go for the more details, if you want to read about the more details. So this is the official page, and here you will get all the information about to whom you can sponsor. You can sponsor your spouse, your partner, your child. If you are a permanent resident, you can sponsor your parents, your grandparents, your children, grandchildren. You can sponsor your adopted child. And if you have any relatives like niece, cousin, brother, then they can sponsor you. So you read about this if you are interested and if you belongs to in this category. Okay, now let's move to the another category, the fourth category, that is the business immigration program. So Canada offers vast amount of opportunity to foreigners who want to do business in Canada. So if you are rich, if you have a good money, then you can go for this option. So this option is best for those who have the good amount of money. And main objective of this program is to encourage the investment and employment in Canada. So now let's open the link for the business immigration program. So this is the official page, and this program is divided into the two main categories. The first category is self-employed persons. It means that if you are self-employed and you want to become an immigrant, then how to apply that? So there are various questions and answers are given. You can read it from the given link. Another which is most important program is startup visa program. So if you are an entrepreneur, you want to do this a startup, you want to buy a business, then this program is the best option for you. Okay, now let's move to the again official page. The next program is Canadian Experience Class. So this is the most important program if you are not eligible in any of the above program. For example, if you do not have the sufficient points in the Express Entry system, if you are not eligible in any of the PNP programs, then what you should do? You should try to get the temporary work permit. We call it as a work permit. And initially, you should go to Canada on the work permit. And after getting the work experience, you can apply for the permanent residence. So it will take some time. It may take around 3 to 5 years to get Canada PR. And you will not get PR directly in this case from the India. Another option is you can go as a foreign student. If you are not eligible in the any of the above program, you can get the student visa. You can get the international education in Canada and your work experience, and you can apply for the Canada residency. So this program basically supports the transition from the temporary residence to the permanent residence. So let's open the link. So this is the link. And again, as I said, mentioned earlier, this program is basically a part of Express Entry, as we saw earlier. So Express Entry is basically having the three program. One is FSWP, Federal Skilled Worker Program, Federal Skilled Trade Program, and Canadian Experience Class. So as you move to Canada as a foreign student or temporary foreign worker, you will get some Canadian experience. And for those people, this program is the best option to get the Canada PR. So you will get all the requirements, eligibility criteria from this. So please go through it if you are interested. So these are the 5 programs. So now what is the conclusion is, we have discussed about top 5 categories of Canada PR. First one is Express Entry Program, Provincial Nominee Program, then Business Class Immigration, Family Class Immigration, and the last one is Canadian Experience Class. We have also discussed about best PNPs for Indians to immigrate in Canada. Now what you should do to obtain Canada PR? You have to identify the best program which matches with your profile and explore the more details from the official website link. Then you create your profile, collect the necessary documents, and apply for Canada permanent visa and become Canadian permanent resident. So my friends, I hope I have answered your queries and questions by sharing this video. If you have any other queries regarding Canada immigration, then please write in the comment box, and please do not forget to subscribe my channel for the latest updates and videos about Canada immigration. And click on the like button if you like the video. Thank you.